Good day. Let us work on some example of this lesson on line space, specifically distance per point from a line. Let us again recall the concept of distance from a point to a line. So we have here a point S that is perpendicular to line L. So we're going to find the distance of this point S to line L. So the formula to be used is equal to the cross product, magnitude rather, of the cross product of the vector PS and vector V all over magnitude of V. So in this example, we have here find the distance from the point to the line. We have the point given 0, 0, 12 and the line in parametric equation form. So with that, let's now find PS or vector PS. So for our vector PS, so if we have this point P given as 0, 0, 12, and this is our point S, whose coordinates can be found? So let's have it as so let us draw first the given point and line L. So this is your point S, which has coordinates 0, 0, 12. So this is your point S, which has coordinates 0, 0, 12. And suppose this is your line L. So we have point S perpendicular to line L. So with that, if this is now the distance to be found, distance of point S to your line L, so that's perpendicular distance, then if we have here a point P whose coordinates can be found from the given parametric equation of your line L, so as you can see, we have last time the formula is XO plus AT and then Y equals YO plus VT and then Z equals ZO plus CT. So for our comparison now of the two equations, we can see now that XO is 0 as well as YO is 0, and then ZO is also 0. So with that, we can say that point P will have coordinate 0, 0, 0. And our vector V we'll have components A, B, C. So in this case, from the given parametric equation of your line L, the components A, B, C will be those coefficients of your T in the given parametric equation of your line. So we have here 4, negative 2, and 2. So with that, we can now find the distance by having the cross product of the two vectors PS and vector V and taking its magnitude over the magnitude of V. So let's have now PS determine vector PS, and it can be found by you have your point P as initial point, point S is a terminal point. So therefore it will be 0 minus 0 is 0, 0 minus 0 is 0, 12 minus 0 is 12. The components of your vector PS is equal to 0, 0, 12. Then for your vector V, it will have components 4, negative 2, 2, as I have written here. So with that, let's now get the cross product of these two vectors. So we have a matrix form, where the first row is ijk, and the second row, the components of your vector PS, so 0, 0, 12. And then the third row will be the components of your vector V. We have it as 4, negative 2, 2. Let's find a determinant of this matrix, 3 by 3 matrix, using the basket method. So I will copy the first two columns. So I, 0, 4, then J, 0, negative 2. Let's now compute for the cross product of these two vectors. So we have I times 0 times, so that is 0, then J times 12 times 4, that's 48J. Then you have here K times 0 times negative 2 is 0, then minus 4 times 0 times K is 0, then negative 2 times 12 times I, that's minus negative 24I. Then this is 2 times 0 times 0 is 0. So therefore, we have this now as 48J plus 24I. But we're going to write this in bracket form. We have it as 24 for I, then for J it's 48, then 0 for K. And if we're going to get now the magnitude of this cross product, so we have now the square root of quantity 24 squared plus 48 squared plus 0 squared. And this gives us our answer. So the value found is 24 squared of 5, or approximately equal to 53.67. Then also, you will get the magnitude of V. So this is your vector V, whose components we have it as 4, negative 2, 2. And then when we are to find its magnitude, we have it equal to square root of 4 squared plus negative 2 squared plus 2 squared equals square root of 24, or 2 square root of 6. So this is also approximately equal to 4.90. Therefore, the distance now of this point S to your line L, using this formula, we have the magnitude of the cross product of the two vectors PS and vector V will be 24 square root of 5 all over the magnitude of V, which is square root of 24. And this is also approximately equal to 2 square root of 30 units, or 10.95 units. So this is the distance from point S to your given line L.